because that's in every picture, right? You're gonna have it with you all the time. Second thing's gonna be your ceremony pictures that you're taking with you for the rest of your life, where they're going to show a lot of your guest tables. Natural light in here.
It looks like a second grader.
Let's do it.
Thanks so much.
You're welcome. Good to meet you.
Let's do it. We got that.
First step, big step.
Okay. We have our florist, I believe, right? We have our florist.
I think so.
We have our florist. We got the cake. The dress is coming. Doing good.
Someone's calling me, I'm sorry.
Doing good. It's okay. Are you scared? You ready to marry me?
Hello? Yes.
Good morning. So I'm going to take you guys on a quick little like fridge and pantry tour. Because I am doing things a little bit different this year, I'm doing more of a meal plan based off my macros than I am just macros and fitting kind of whatever I want into it. The more things you control in a science experiment, the less likely you are to have like variables that play into your results. So, start with the fridge.
I get all my veggies from frozen veggies. I don't count anything green, and then I don't count peppers and onions. That stuff is just the fun stuff from like when I was in surgery and things like that. But I mean, I don't really crave that stuff, so I just leave it there. So zucchini, I got green beans, another green beans, peppers and onions, and that's pretty much all the veggies I like to eat. Let me go over here. So I love these ice things. There, like a study came out about aspartame, something in all like diet sodas and stuff. And I love, love, love Coke Zero, but Brandon doesn't want me eating or drinking it because, you know, it's like linked to cancer or something. But I have these, and these don't have that in there. So they're like a sparkling ice water type thing. And then I have almond milk unsweetened for like coffee or things like that. And then I have some ground beef we made, rice, which I'll get to in a minute. But then I have Dallas Prep Kitchen. If you've watched the past video, I use them for meal prep stuff. I am mainly ordering like meats because that's what I choose to spend my like monthly allowance from the company on. And I bought chicken right before because I forgot I was getting a shipment. But that, this is like the best reheated chicken you could have. You know how chicken like starts getting a little weird when you reheat it? I don't know. I just really have always hated microwaved chicken. So it surprises me that I love that stuff. It's so tender. Ground bison is my favorite. They like, it's super finely like chopped up. Love that. Lots of flavor, more flavor than beef for sure. And then I have steak, and they cook it kind of like a medium rare, and then when you heat it up, it gets like more medium, or you know, just like a pink-ish color. And then we have eggs, and down here I have mush. So this company sends me stuff. I do have a code, it's Kerrigan, for I think it's 20% off, but I don't make any money off of this company. I just like to support small business, and I'm sorry it's so dark, and I found them on Shark Tank, so really cool. They only have like a few ingredients. Of course, that one doesn't have ingredients. That was a secret flavor. A few ingredients on each one, and they're dairy-free. What is it? What else? So it's almond milk, apples, rolled oats, dried cranberries, cinnamon, and sea salt. Nothing crazy in here. Super good. Love it. This is when I was doing like more macro-friendly stuff, but I don't want to just throw it out, so. Another thing is Brandon and I went dairy free mainly for his skin. He has psoriasis, and then my like acne prone skin, and I feel like it's helped a lot. I just got a chemical peel, so it like caused a little bit of flare up, but it's getting better. I feel like it really is. So going back to that, we cut out all dairy, so you won't find any dairy anywhere in our house anymore. And then these are blueberries. It has antioxidants, and it has vitamins in there that also help with your skin. So, oh, and then of course, I haven't broken into them yet, but cucumbers, and I have my sugar-free packets in the fridge. And then I have ginger because I have a sensitive stomach, and that really helps And then obviously lettuce. Otherwise, we will go to the pantry. Hey, Joey. Bear, come here. Bear.
I have dirty dishes, don't look at them.
Hey, can you try in the pantry? Okay, so in the pantry, I'm gonna start from the bottom. Brandon's new coach wanted him to do whey instead of vegan protein. And like for the last few days, he had a really bad reaction, like stomach wise to whey. So I think I'm just going to like put that over there. It doesn't count. We're not eating it anymore. Or he's not eating it anymore, and I'm definitely not eating it. I have creatine here, and then I have my 1UP, like my extra supplements. Most of my supplements are in a cabinet, like over there, but extra supplements here that I haven't really opened yet. But EAA, fiber, collagen, tricarb, which I sometimes use this in intro workout. It's either that or Gatorade usually. For the carbs, like intro workout, usually later in prep. And then I also have Gatorade Zero because it tastes good. And then this stuff that I apparently can't have anymore. I'm taking I cleaned out all of our perishable foods, and I'm going to either take them, like, I know my brother would like some of this stuff, or like take them to, I mean, I can't really take opened food to a shelter or anything, but like, you get it. Not here. After that, we go to the carb shelf, is what I call it. I kept it out of there, and I'll talk about that in a second. But I kept out my pancake mix because some refeeds I'm going to have something like that. Then we have cream of rice, cream of wheat. We usually put that in like smoothies or, you know, shakes or something for the carb source. Of course, rice cakes, old fashioned oats. And then I have different oatmeals here. Brandon eats like the normal packets. And then these are my like poverty macro packets, which I'm not really there yet, but you know, it's just like 18 carbs. I love these, the Better Oats 100 calorie packs. And then these are my leftover pumpkin ones. They're all regular calorie too, but they taste good, so I left them. And then I also get the lower sugar Quaker. Eventually, I'm going to move over it all to sweetening my like plain oats with stevia and cinnamon, but this is just easier right now. And then I kept these because I didn't want to throw them away, but I don't know when I'll use them. Oh, I don't know, I probably will never use them. And then we're almost out, but jasmine rice. And on another video, I can show y'all how I cook my jasmine rice because it always comes out absolutely perfect. Okay, after that, it's another shelf. Usually there's our protein right here, but it's just on the counter right now. I have nutritional yeast, which I like sprinkle on a lot of stuff. It's really good, like vitamins and I think fiber. I don't know a lot about it, but I've heard it's good for you and I like it. And then I kept out my sugar-free syrup. There's just like refill of olive oil over there. These like salad spritz strawberries. I've actually never tried it, but it looks good. It sounded good when I was dieting. And then all of these are like my stevias or like Mio's or something like that. And I try to keep, oh, and the coveted Jelly Rancher packets. If you sprinkle this on your cucumbers, you get diet apples. And then like Jell-O packets. I just didn't really know where to put them, but I didn't want to throw them away. Usually you can make like macro friendly things with that, but that's not what I'm doing this year. So I think they're just gonna stay right there. And then I have my extra sugar-free jelly. Oh, I forgot to show you all that in the fridge, but I have like blueberry, peach, and strawberry. And then Brandon's peanut butter, because I don't eat peanut butter because it also makes me break out. So up here behind all of this is all my food that is like long lasting that would be perfectly fine to eat in like if I were just counting macros. But since I am doing a meal plan, I'm kind of eating the same thing day to day. So I don't want it to be like trying to fit things into my macros this year just because I want it to be simple, I want it to be quick. And I want to, like I said, control as many variables as possible. So
It's up there. And I don't even have to see the things that tempt me. I know not everybody's able to do that in their house, but we can do that in my house, so I did it. And then otherwise, this is the last thing, which I need to get out of here before I really start getting hungry. Excuse the dust.
Halloween candy. Halloween candy exhibit 2. So
that's where we're at right now, food wise. And that's all I got. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, or this little sharing of my, what I eat in a day. I can show you a full day of eating, kind of like how I cook things, the amounts and whatever. Just let me know if you want to see that, drop a comment below. Otherwise, enjoy the rest of the video.
Mama told me not to sell word. Mama 17-5, same color t-shirt.
White.
Mama told me not to sell word. Mama 17-5, same color t-shirt.
Yeah.
Mama told me not to sell word. Mama 17-5, color t-shirt. Mama told me not to sell word. Mama 17-5, same color t-shirt.
Away now, so it's just like it can be done, but
I guess it won't be as easy as, not easy, but you know what I mean, like last year. Because I didn't, I think I had a 22 or 23 week off season compared to like a 52 week off season the year before that. Because I took off all of 2018 because I could not prep, my body wouldn't respond. So maybe I'm somebody that needs that much time, but I'm trying to push not to be that person. It can be done, but I will have to go lower in food than ever just because that's what my body's gonna take. I'm up for the challenge though. Like you guys probably know if you followed like my last prep, Brandon does not give any compliments to me, or I told him to be a little bit nicer to our other clients just because some people are like not as tough skinned as I am, but he does not give any compliments to me. If anything, he like fires me up by doubting me, which sounds dumb, but as a coach, I get it. I'm hard to respond, but I don't mess up. If I can't get that lean, it's not because of my compliance, it's because my body needed more of a rest. But we're not even there yet. We have so much work to do. We're not even 2 weeks in. I'm going for this show, and I'm going to make this show, and I'm going to look even better than I did last year. But that's where my head's at. I just wanted to be honest. And then the other part of that is I feel like, so Brandon said, looking at my check-in pictures from my back pose, that I look kind of like softer. Like I have more fat and less muscle on my butt. Like, you know, glutes, hamstrings, I think. But, I mean, I don't see it, but I also can understand what he's saying from a coach's view. Maybe he sees it more than I do. But from sitting on the couch for that long, I'm sure I did lose some muscle, which I've always been told my legs are a little overdeveloped for bikini, and that's why I need to get my upper body bigger, because my upper body is plenty big, like compared to everybody else, but I have bigger legs, so I need to make myself symmetrical from the bottom to the top. So maybe it's a good thing I lost some muscle, but I don't want to. I need to, like, I can lose some muscle in my quads. Like, I haven't squatted since October because of surgery, and then just because I know I need to bring them down. But I don't want to lose my glutes and hamstrings because I feel like my back pose is kind of what gets me in the top runners in national shows. I always get moved after we turn around. So like Sandy says, you know, we're all facing the front, like ladies face the curtain, turn around, turn back to the front, and then they switch me to the middle. That happened on all of my shows last year. So I can't lose that, you know, that's my strong point. So you saw the workout I just did today. I am dying and I'm definitely gonna feel that tomorrow. My legs are still shaking and I think I still have cardio. But yeah, I just wanted to give that honest talk. I don't know how long this video is gonna be, but I do have a new person working with right here. And so between him and Sam and everything, we'll get this rolling a little bit quicker. I think that's all I have to say today. Sticking to the heavy movements, not doing any bullshit exercises, and we're gonna get this. So thank you for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, tell your friends, all the stuff, and I'm about to get lean.